Hey, it's Patti Scharf, CPA and co-founder of Catching Clouds, the leader in e-commerce accounting, and today we're going to talk about Shopify. It seems like every single day I see on some kind of forum or something where somebody is asking me, hey, what is the best integration to use with Shopify and Xero or QuickBooks Online? And I always kind of cringe because I want to make sure that everybody understands what the potential problems are with there, because there are like seven different issues and I never know which one somebody's going to have. So let's go through this pretty quickly. If you log into Shopify and you go to the payout screen, you'll see this total here. And this total is the amount that actually lands in your bank account. This is the amount that you want to make sure that you got, because these are the orders that were made and this is the amount that landed in your bank. People who are less familiar with accounting, they will just see these deposits in their bank account and just go, sales, done. And that's actually not right. As you can see, it's broken out between the gross sales, and there are refunds in there, there are adjustments for the refunds, there are fees associated with this, and all of that needs to be recorded separately in your accounting so that it makes sense. So then people are like, okay, then I'll just record these, boom, 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 boom. It's also not quite that easy, because if you look at any one of these payout dates, so let's say April 10th, you will look and see that there are like a gazillion orders in here. And some of them were made yesterday and some were on Sunday and some were on Saturday. And you really need to record those in the right period. And the gross charges that they have here, there might be shipping income that you want to keep track of. That's in addition to the cost of the product or something like that. So you really want to break these out into more detail, okay? But I don't care how much you love accounting, nobody wants to go in and record these one by one. I mean, that is just too much brain damage for anybody. Let's say you're really simple, you're just starting out, you have maybe one sale a day or a few sales a week. It's really easy to stay on top of. You would just go into your payout screen, you click on your specific order, and in your QuickBooks Online file or your Xero file, you can set up, let's say, for QuickBooks Online, you would set up a recurring sales receipt that has the basic information that you typically are selling. And then you just have to update the amounts and the date. You have the payee go to Shopify and you're done. Boom. In Xero, you would set up a repeating invoice. Same thing. Have your customer be Shopify and just record the details of your sale the way you want it, done. If you want to keep track of your inventory in there, great. If you don't. It doesn't really matter. But let's say you are now up to 10 transactions a day and it's kind of starting to take some time and it's annoying you and you want to automate it some way. I think this is where most of the questions come from. How do I automate it? And I would say at 10 orders a day or less, okay, you could probably use the Shopify integration. If you go to the App Store, you'll see something for Xero. You'll also see one for Intuit QuickBooks Online. And you'll notice that when you go through the reviews, you get lots of ones, twos, ones, five. Like, they either love it or hate it. And this is for both systems. The reason is it really depends on the complexity of the store, whether it's going to work for you well or not. If you have a lot of payment processors, so if you're using Stripe and Shopify Payments and PayPal, the integration is only going to reconcile Shopify Payments. The others, it'll record the orders, but then you still have to reconcile the other stuff by hand. You have to record the other fees by hand. And people who don't understand that get this kind of jumbled mess and they don't know how to reconcile it and don't know what to do with it. Accountants might be able to handle that more easily than, say, just somebody who's never touched accounting before, but that's something to be aware of. The other problem is if you're selling more than 1,000 orders a day, Xero in particular will not pull in more than 1,000 orders a day. And even if QuickBooks Online does, which I'm not convinced that it does, it will start overloading the system because neither systems were built to be a database like that. They weren't built to hold that much data. All that information already lives in Shopify. You don't need it in your accounting system also. So you should really just be recording everything as a summary amount of information. The other problem is if you're selling like 3,000 SKUs, stock keeping units, so the different types of products you're selling, if you're selling like a gazillion different types of product, then it's going to overwhelm QuickBooks Online. It's going to overwhelm Xero. So what do you do? The short answer is that you should really be recording everything as summary information. We have yet to find a tool that really handles this well, except for in unique circumstances. But we have a method that we've created that works pretty well. If you want to get more information about that, you can look down below in our links. We've included a link to our Accounting for Shopify course. It's about 4.5 hours long and covers cost of goods sold in addition to how to post income from your Shopify store. So I hope you liked this video. If you did, please hit the like button, share it with your friends, comment, and subscribe if you haven't already. And we'll catch you next time.